Okay, in this video, we're going to look at texturing a different sort of environment, texturing terrain, that is the ground beneath our feet, rather than a man-made structure. Okay, so I'm going to delete this default cube, and I'm going to add a mesh plane. And I'm going to scale that up to about the size of the grid. Of course, you could do yours larger, scale it up a bit more. So I'm pressing S and dragging the mouse back and then clicking to set the scale. Okay, so the first thing we need to get some detail are some more faces. At the moment we've only got one. If we go into edit mode, we can right click and see that we've just got that one face. So here I'm going to click subdivide a good few times. Now you can see I've got 1024 by 1024 faces. This should give us a reasonable amount of detail, but of course the more faces we add, the harder the computer has to work. So once we've divided it all up, we change our mode to Sculpt Mode. Now Sculpt Mode has lots of brushes here. You go to Sculpt Tool and you can see all sorts of different things there related to what you use in sculpture, scraping and smoothing and things like that. The one we're going to use is Draw, and as you can see, as I drag over the surface, it starts to raise it. Now I can control how much it's raised using the strength over here. So if I turn the strength up more, it raises it up higher. And you'll see as well that if I go over once and then go over again, it just continues to raise that up. So I'm just making a few lumps and bumps here. Now this is a good time to refer to any level plans that you might have, so you can make sure that you're getting things in the right place. The radius is how large an area we affect at any given time. So there you go. Okay, into town there. Let's turn it down a bit. And eventually you'll have all your lumps and bumps where you want them. So I'm going to do something like that. Okay. So obviously you can spend a bit longer on this than I am. Now, all these bits of, well, this sculpting that I've done is quite faceted. We can see the faces very easily. So there's another brush here that's quite useful, just to kind of make our terrain a little bit more subtle, and that is smooth. And we can just go back over that, and it just smooths it out for us. Makes it a little more natural and less faceted and sort of squared off in places. Be careful you don't smooth too much though, because you might take away any features that you want to you've added. So I'm just going to go over and just give it a little bit of a smooth. There we go. Okay. Once you're happy with your design, what we do then is we need to unwrap the UVs. So we go back to edit mode, and scroll down on the left hand side to find unwrap, and then we'll go unwrap. Now, so that we can see our UVs, what we can do is go over here and just pull the corner like that, and we can drag on one of these. So we're looking at our 3D view here. I'm just going to change this view down here to UV stroke image editor. And that shows us a flat image of what our terrain looks like there. And what we need to do is we need to choose new, and then here I'm just going to call it terrain and leave everything else the same. I'm going to press OK, and I can zoom out a bit. Now over here, some people find it easier to use texture paint mode over in this view. Some people find it easier in this view. I prefer this one, so I'm just going to like that for a bit. And then over here, what we'll see, when we're in texture paint mode, you can see that we've got colours here, so I could choose blue there for that, there we go, and just paint where I want it blue. And you can see that it's updating our flat image here, our texture. If we scroll down, we've got a few different settings. Got a texture here. I can press new. Oh, that's clouds. So instead of clouds, I'll get something else in a moment. And here as well, we've got texture masks and strokes. We can change the stroke to airbrush. Gives it a little bit more of a natural blend. And a few other settings that we don't particularly need to look at this moment. Okay. Over on the right hand side, we'll have a look at our materials, and I'm going to press new, and it's going to be, I should call it terrain mat, and here in the texture panel, I'm going to press this button here. Oh, no, I'll go back to that one. I'll press new. Oops. And in fact, instead of clouds, let's go with image or movie. And what we need to do is just scroll down to this bit where we've got new and open. And here we choose terrain. So it's fetching our terrain image. And is it going to be allowing us to? So I'm going to go terrain texture. Good to the idea to name things. Okay, now we can press this little thing here, the type of texture, and instead of clouds, we choose image or movie. You will have hopefully got some different textures for the ground in your environment, and this is where you can open them up. So I'm going to go to mine, which I've previously downloaded, just going on to Google, and ground, and the first one I'm going to do, I've got this one, Skanky Grass. I've called it Skanky Grass because it's grass, but it looks a bit rubbish. I'm just going to paint directly on there like that. Now, if you change your radius, you can change the scale of this. Anyway, I'm just going to cover the whole lot like that. Okay. If you do want to cover the whole area and you can see a few bits missing like this, you can come over into here. Seems to have slowed down on me an awful lot. Just come out here. Okay. So just get all that bit filled in. Okay. And then I'm going to apply another material to it. I'm going to add some sand. So here, I'm just going to rename this one grass in this box that currently says texture. So if I need to, I can always come back to it. And then I'm going to press, oops, I pressed that too many times there. Instead of grass 001, I'm going to call this one sand. And instead of the skanky grass JPEG, I'm going to swap that for beach. Open that up. I'm just going to change my radius and I can turn the strength up. And again, you can use an airbrush. Oops. And that should hopefully just sort of slightly blend the edges a bit more than just a normal brush would. I'm just going to put a load of sand down like that. Again, you can spend a lot more time on this than I am. And you can see that in some places it's sort of blended together a bit. And here I've got sort of gone over it. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to pop back to the grass there and recover that. There we go. Beautiful. Okay, so very simply textured environment there. Of course, you could add plenty more if you wanted to. Rock, for example, and just swap that for my lovely mossy rock image that I've got. I might put that around here somewhere. If you are painting and it does look far too big, you can scroll down here to image mapping, I think. Not image mapping. Sometimes if you zoom in, it seems to change the scale of it. Okay, well here's the size, there we go. So if I change that to, let's say, scale it up to like 2. And that should make it a little bit smaller. There we go. And go back to grass. Just to get rid of some of that. So, not by any stretch of the imagination, the world's greatest texturing done by me there. But it does show you how to get those different textures onto one thing in a very easy and sort of intuitive fashion. Last thing we must do though here is, because this is going to be our texture, and you might find that in Blender Game, when we turn GLSL on, you might find that if we render it out as a standalone player, whenever it decides to do it, there we are, complete darkness. Okay, what we must do is make sure that we've updated this image. So image, save as image, terrain PNG. I'm going to put that into my textures folder. Like that. Now you should hopefully see that in the standalone player. There we are, we can see those textures on there. Okay, so that should give you a good start at creating your game world.